Hey everybody, I'm Pat from Track Machine Tools, and I'm assuming if you're watching this video, it's because you're considering replacing one of your old ProtoTracks with the new ProtoTrack KMX. My purpose today is to give you a good idea on the things that are different. There are some things that we've streamlined, things that make it a lot easier to use, things that give it more power than the current control you have at this time. And I want to start by showing you the keyboard itself. If you look at the screen, you'll notice that it's a little bit different because the buttons are all on the right hand side instead of on the bottom. And the biggest difference you're going to notice here is there's no edit button. I'll explain that in a minute, but basically all your editing is streamlined now to where it's inside of the programming so that you can make your adjustments on the fly and keep moving on to the next piece of the information. Okay, so if I start up here at the top and I go to the DRO mode, okay, so as you can see, the DRO is something you're already going to be familiar with. It won't take you any time to get used to it. It does have a few more powerful features than your older one did, but other than that, it is something that you're going to get moving with right away. Okay, so I'm going to switch and I'm going to go into the program mode where you'll see the real big changes, okay? First of all, I can start at the beginning, I can start in the middle, I can go to the end, any of those things, all right? I'm just going to go to the beginning, and what you're going to see in here is I've got a standard program in here. It's got a bolt hole pattern and a pocket and some other shapes. But what I'm really in here for right now is to show you how the editing works, right? So in the editing part of this, I can move from page to page to page. Okay, I can go forwards, I can go backwards, I can go up and down from question to question, and at any time I can push the look button and see what I have. For instance, let's say that this radius right here on this part needs to be a different size because I punched in a wrong number. Then what I would do is I would find that part of the program, and I would, once I know where the problem is, then I would look at where I made the mistake, and in this case I'm assuming it's this Conrad right here. I can come down to here. It was supposed to be a quarter inch. I make the change, you'll see that the change is instant. So the biggest difference is that I never have to bounce around from one mode to another trying to find the right place to fix the problem, go back to the program mode, see if it's right. It's all instant as I work, okay? The other thing that I want to show you is on the very first page of the program, you'll notice there's a button down here that says delete events. So this is how I take chunks of the program out like I used to do in the edit mode. And the last thing I used to do in the edit mode was I used to have to go in to erase a current program. Now that's covered under the program in and out mode. All right, so I'm going to go back into here and I'm going to show you the things that are different now. All right, so back into program mode, I'm going to go to the end. And in here, the first thing you're going to see is that in here, my drilling events are exactly the same as what you're used to. Positions, drills, and bolt hole patterns, okay? Mills and arcs, no different than what you're used to seeing all the time. The big differences start here. So I'm gonna first of all go to pockets. And in pockets, you have your standard circles and rectangles, but then you also have a regular pocket, which allows me to build a pocket point to point using mills and arcs. And it also has AGE programming in it, which will allow me to help with the math and figure out the dimensions if they're missing on the print. I'll cover AGE in detail in a moment. But for right now, I also want you to know that an irregular pocket allows you to control the step over, how much the cutter is cutting with, and also adds finish cuts to all the pockets, all right? Face mill is another new feature. Face mill allows me to describe a part by how long and how wide it is. Once I give it the size of the tool diameter, it creates a serpentine, which will clean off the top of the program, or top of the part, and be completed, okay? So if I hit return here and I go to profiles, profiles, circles, and rectangles, exactly what you're used to, okay? Irregular profile, again, has AGE programming, allows me to give a finish cut, okay? And it'll help me with creating the whole program piece by piece, point by point, okay? Last but not least, I want to cover the subroutines. In the subroutines, not only do you have the older version, which has subs of repeats, mirror images, and rotations. You now have copy events to do all three of those things. Copy events will allow you to make new pieces and save the old ones the way they are. So if they're slightly different, I don't have to start at the beginning. I can just copy and then edit the new pieces. Okay? I'm going to get out of the program mode right now and I'm going to cover setup mode. In the setup mode, I have my tool table like I discussed before. So in here you'll see I have different tools and I have different lengths of tools. So each tool measures off the base tool. Therefore, when I set 1Z0 in the DRO mode, all of the tools will accordingly know where that Z0 is. Also in the setup mode, probably the biggest difference is we've added this feature called Verify Part. In verify part, I am able to define the stock of what size my piece part is, okay? And then I have a button here that says make part. And when I go into here, it'll actually show me a solid model of what my completed part is going to look like. So it really takes all the guessing out of it. It's more high tech than using the toolpath. And you see that the part is complete and everything looks right before I ever go to actually make the part. Okay, I'm gonna get back out of here. And last but not least, I'm gonna go into the program in and out mode. Program in and out is the same as what you're used to, except for you'll notice right here that here's where you erase a current program. And right here you see something that says open temp. The reason you have that is you have the ability to save a temporary file, which will keep all of your part information, your tooling information, your zeros and everything else. As long as the machine doesn't move while it's shut off, it'll be in exactly the same place when you open the temp file. Okay? Run mode is no different than it was before. It's either start in the beginning or start somewhere in the middle. Math help is what you're used to. It has all the same benefits for helping to figure out missing dimensions and stuff. However, with AGE programming, I think you're going to find that this is used very seldom. Okay, lastly, in the three-axis version of the control, the differences are this. I can add dwell to my drill cycles. I can adjust the type of PEC cycles that I have in my drilling by either having fixed, variable, or chip breaking. I can add depth of cut to my profiles and to also my pockets, and I can adjust the amount of finish cut that I want to have. Next, I'm going to cover AGE programming, followed by tracking.